We're joined by Yashodhara Raje Scindia. She's, of course, a senior leader of the BJP in Madhya Pradesh. She's joining us from Bhopal. She also, of course, happens to be the aunt of Jyotiraditya Scindia. Thank you very much indeed, ma'am, for joining us. As we all try to make sense of the big dhamaka today, did you have any idea this was coming?
Yes, as a family person, of course I did.
Okay. And what do you think triggered it?
Family members are privy to certain things.
Okay. What?
The same thing that triggered my mother to leave the Congress.
Okay.
The same thing that led to my mother leaving the Congress.
Mm-hmm. What? What is that? Spell that out for us.
A certain amount of... it's not rocket science.
Hmm.
You don't like to be... I'm now going to speak about my mother. When Dwarka Prasad Mishra was all in all, and my mother was in the Congress party, and he refused to listen to her, and she was a tall Maharani in those days.
Yes.
She had a lot of respect from the Chambal Sambhag.
Right.
She had a lot of MLAs and all who were respecting her. And Dwarka Prasad ji would just not listen to her and overrode everything that she would say.
Hmm.
And she felt very, very sad. Jisko kehte hain aghat
ji
in Hindi. She was very sad about it. And finally, she just ended up leaving because he wasn't giving her the respect due.
So you're saying the same thing has happened
for
to Jyotir?
Respect where somebody does shashtang or...
Hmm. You're saying the same thing has happened to Jyotiraditya? He's been sidelined by the Congress.
I'm not saying that, Srinivasan. I'm just saying that what are the visuals we see for the last so many months of my nephew within the Congress party? Those visuals I'm putting together for you and your viewers to say that in the end we have to talk in a dignified way on this whole issue.
There are
reasons for people doing this. We are not mad. There are reasons that people get up and make such a big step in their lives. The life of Jyotiraditya Scindia is also going to change. It's not just the BJP, it's not just the Congress, but it's his life that will also change. He's taken a very big step.
No, it is a big step.
And does it work out? Doesn't it work out?
Yeah.
That's
It's a big step. But you know, when you say that one is not mad to do it, but at the same time, there is of course the view that this is just a deeply cynical move that he's done. He lost he couldn't win his Lok Sabha election, and he was basically rudderless. And so this is his way of coming back, that he gets a Rajya Sabha seat perhaps, he gets a ministry in the central government, and this is just purely
don't use the word rudderless. I don't think you should use the word rudderless.
Okay.
That's not a kosher phrase at this point.
Okay.
Because if he was rudderless and if he was so useless, then the BJP also would not be seeing anything in him. The BJP is welcoming him because he brings value to the table. Nobody is going to welcome a Congress person unless he's a leader and he's of substantial value.
No, I'm not saying, by the way...
They had no connections with Jyotiraditya Scindia.
I'm not suggesting that he brings no value. I just meant that there's one argument that he's...
I know what you're saying.
That he's done this purely out of self-interest.
How can you be...
I meant Jyotiraditya, there's one argument, one criticism, that he's betrayed the party which has nurtured him for all these years purely out of self-interest to become perhaps a minister in the central government.
But doesn't anybody's... how many people are not working with even 1% of self-interest within any party? Let's think about that a little. I mean, if we really talk about brass tacks...
Yes.
Politics today is not the politics it was 50 years ago, where everybody was, wonderful and, they did it with a certain point of view and for the building the nation and whatever.
Yes.
In the end, if a man feels that he is capable of contributing to a party, and he's been in that party all his life. I agree with you completely.
Yes.
And he's there to contribute also. In the end, he was a senior minister in their governments.
Yeah.
He was a senior leader. The Congress took his help. If you noticed all the rallies that happened,
yes,
it was not a rally that was simply just Kamal Nath's rally or simply Digvijay's rally.
Right.
He happened to be there in all the rallies, in leading the party from the front.
Mm.
After that, one sees
yes.
that the connection started breaking a little bit. Now, again, I'm talking about the visuals that I was seeing
okay.
on your channels or on any
right.
other
you're
channels.
You're saying in terms of what
there
is publicly...
There was a certain amount of disconnect that was
fair
happening.
Enough. You're saying in terms of what is publicly available information, this is the day that he's picked to do this, by the way, as we know, is the anniversary of his late father, Madhavrao Scindia, who's himself a tall Congress leader. Jairam Ramesh, Congress leader, tweeting saying, would late Madhavrao Scindia have approved of this? He called the BJP desh-drohis.
Srinivas, didn't my brother also leave the Congress party and form his own party called Ugta Hua Suraj Symbol?
He did.
Did he not?
He did, but he didn't join
did
the BJP.
Did he not have an issue with his own party at one point?
He did, but he didn't join the BJP.
No, but he went and fought those elections with my mother's total help, where the BJP stood down and didn't put a candidate up against him. What does that mean? So he wasn't doing it singularly. He was doing it with my mother's help.
Right.
And my mother did stand down and the BJP party stood down to help him. And he stood and won. Because we also presume that he would most probably take a second step and come back to the BJP. In the end, he did start off from there, no?
Okay.
But
so you're saying that you're saying
strong words when he left.
Okay.
Party.
So you're saying this is almost a ghar vapsi. You're saying this is almost, in a sense, then a ghar vapsi for Jyotiraditya.
Absolutely, it's not an almost. It's a ghar vapsi.
It's a ghar. Okay.
Because
he's not formally.
Dada, when he first came from England.
Yes.
He came.
Go ahead.
And joined the Jansang.
Right.
Then he left.
Right.
My mother had joined the Congress, but she was insulted very badly by Dwarka Prasad Mishra. Very, very badly. She was a young widow by then.
Okay.
Her husband had not been keen at all for her to join the Congress party. She did it because Honorable Nehru, Mr. Nehru, asked her to join the party. But she was given a very rough time
right.
by D.P. Mishra. And she left, joined and put together the Samvid Sarkar.
Okay.
And then there was history.
But let me ask you this.
So,
okay.
obviously there's a problem there.
Okay, yeah. you're saying there's a problem. Okay, you're saying there's a problem with the Congress. But what about within the BJP itself? What sort of BJP is your nephew now entering? This is the Narendra Modi Amit Shah BJP. Is it still kind to the Scindias? Based on your own experience.
But the Prime Minister met him, no? The Prime Minister met him. Yes. Why would the Prime Minister meet him if he was not welcome into the party? And it was the Home Minister that took him to the Prime Minister. So why would the Prime Minister have even met him? He doesn't meet quite a few people and yet he meets a lot of people. But he chose to meet him, gave him time to meet him and welcomed him.
Okay.
So, you know, the Scindias are not that bad to deal with. We have a certain way of thinking. And we know the kind of workers we are. We are all
okay.
very, very hard workers. You've
but
seen my sister
you,
in Rajasthan. You've.
I want to ask. Yes, of course. I've seen her and.
Yes.
And we've seen her and we've seen the Scindias at work. But I want to ask you in conclusion. You're saying that this is all about when you know the point is made. He's doing it out of self-interest. You're saying it's all about now the politics today of self-interest. And ideology doesn't matter. I mean, here is someone for his entire political career.
No, I'm not. No, no,
hold on.
Let me finish.
Who has for his entire political career attacked the BJP.
No, no, no.
He's attacked the BJP. He said the BJP is communal. It's a party of hate, etc., etc. Now, all that's forgotten.
So, can I say something about that?
Yes.
Can I say something about that?
Yes.
Which opposition party does not take the party who is ruling and try and tear them apart. Please tell me which opposition party doesn't that. Why do you call them the opposition party? Then you should just have social parties and
then
have
that's ideology.
And everybody will be, it'll all be hunky-dory. But call them the opposition party because that's their job.
No, but that's also because presumably that's the ideology you subscribe to. That's the ideology you subscribe to. You're taking that view not just because you're in the opposition, but because you think that that's your ideology.
I would say I'm not going to his defense.
Okay.
But I do say I'm a believer in it.
Okay.
That the Honorable Prime Minister has don't raise your eyebrows now because I can't see you on the screen. But the Honorable Prime Minister has done many things. There will be always certain people who will talk against this. But there are certain things where he has tried to bring the nation on a world level, where he's tried to do things for the Aam Janta. The reason why I say this, and I'm going to back it up, is that in my constituency, I have taken some of his yojanas.
Okay.
And because I have sat and put it into every single house. Give me a second.
No. I don't want to.
That he has done this.
Right.
Wait. Let me finish because you asked me a question. So let me finish that. Don't be naughty. So, when everybody inside knows that in their constituency, if today they apply even 5 of the yojanas that the center is doing, they will be able to win.
Okay.
The Pradhan Mantri Avas Yojana, the Chula Wala Yojana. There are so many yojanas that he is bringing, wait a second, to the nth man.
Okay, you're
so
saying that...
there are certain issues where everybody is with my Prime Minister.
Okay.
And underneath, there is an underlying feeling. And if you're not going to give an outlet to a person to do the work that he needs to do,
yes,
he is going to get frustrated. Now, I'm not here to be a brief, to lay a brief for him.
Yes.
So I'm not going to get into all this personal stuff.
No, but I'm just saying...
I'm just trying to surmise why he did this.
Okay, I understand where you're coming from. But I just want to leave you with my final thought on this, that at the end of the day, his exit has led to the virtual, I won't say collapse, but a very large number of Congress MLAs have defected, have resigned and are likely to defect. And it's basically the BJP stealing the election.
And there are many more in the pipeline.
Many more in the pipeline. But you're stealing the mandate. That's the BJP stealing the mandate.
Yes.
You didn't get the mandate in Madhya Pradesh. You're stealing the mandate.
No, we're not stealing. I don't like that word at all. You have to correct that word. In Vidhan Sabha, that word gets expunged. How do I expunge your word that you just said about stealing? I don't like that. See, we were only 4 apart. If we had needed, we could have gone to the independents also.
Right.
We could have also gone to the SP and the BSP, and we would have cobbled up our government. But Shivraji, at that particular point, did not want to do that.
Okay.
I'm serious about this.
Okay.
We were, I think, four MLAs apart. We could have also done the independent scene. We could have also done the SP and BSP.
Yeah.
We just chose not to because he talked to the Prime Minister and the Home Minister, and they were not very keen at that particular point. I think it was a decision taken by the higher-ups. I'm not going to get into that.
Okay.
But stealing is not the right word.
Okay, all right.
We have to change that.
We can debate that, but thank you very much indeed. I know you're in a rush.
This is NDTV, and you also have a dignified way of doing this, and people are watching.
Okay.
We don't steal.
We'll find better ways of putting it. But thank you so much for joining us.